Hello and welcome to ZAPSIS 101. Today we will review how to download and upload files just in a few clicks using ZAPSIS SSIS Secure FTP Task. So to start, just open your Visual Studio, click File, New Project, select Integration Services Project to create one, press OK. So for start, I will show you how to download a file. So in SSIS toolbox, find ZS Secure FTP Task, drag it over, right click, press edit. Storage action is already set for us to download the file. So to proceed, you will need to create a new connection to your FTP or SFTP server. As you see, protocol has two options because Secure FTP Task supports not only Classic FTP but SFTP as well, and FTPS, which is FTP over SSL too. So we will be using SFTP. So now just let me fill in the fields: localhost, user, and password. For now, I will just test the connection to see if everything is okay. We can move on, press OK. So now we will have to select the path in FTP server we want to download files from. I'm interested in out directory. I will want to download all the files from it. So I will just replace it with wildcard. If it had more directories, I could set a recursive scan. I can leave it. Then let's set the target path, which is our local path. I click OK. Let me show you that this directory is empty. Now let me run the package. Oh, as you see, all files are downloaded. So now let me show you how to upload files with some advanced settings. So I will show you how to upload and how to make the path you want to upload to dynamic, so, or parametric. So let's name it folder, let's say. Let's name it folder, give it data type to string and value to in. Now let's edit the task. We can use the same task. As you see, we have several other options here, like not only download, but of course upload, which we'll be using now, and delete file or folders and any other useful ones too. So okay, let's set to upload. Now we will be using our local path. Yes, and I will show you how to upload. We will be using the same path to upload the files. So, and let's say we care only about PDFs. So to upload only PDFs, go to advanced filter and in include regex, enter the regex you need, which will include only PDFs. Here you can use exclude regex to exclude certain files. We could just use, of course, here CSV. Okay, let's go back. In the target connection, we can use the same connection. And here for path, we could select it manually like this. But let's say we want to make it parametric or dynamic. So we press this blue button. We go here and we can just insert our parameter here. and it will get the files of this path, which will be calculated on runtime. Okay, and now press OK. I save. I can show you that in folder is empty. Now let's run the package. Let's refresh, and here you see PDFs are here. Finally, I will show you how to get file contents directly into a variable. Okay, we can use the same task again. I just right click and press edit. I select appropriate storage action, which is where it is. Read FTP file content as text. I'm using the same connection. Now let's select the path, say out, and I want to get the contents of this invoice. We will save the result, the text of that file, into a new variable, and let's name it data. Press OK, click OK. And I will use also ZS logging task, which is a very handy task. It will help us look at the variable value once it is set by SFTP task. Okay, I'm saving it and running. And here you go. Logging task loaded CSV with this kind of data. In this video, you learn how to use Zapis's SFTP task for basic FTP actions. For more videos like this, please subscribe to Zapis's YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.